Problem set 6, question number 5. The question is, prove the followings. And the first example from the question number 5 is, we have to prove that sec theta into the bracket 1 minus sin theta into sec theta plus tan theta, that is equals to 1. We have to prove that the LHS and the RHS are equal. So, here first we will write LHS as it is, that is sec theta into the bracket 1 minus sin theta into the bracket sec theta plus tan theta, that is LHS. We have to simplify this LHS and we have to get the RHS. See, in the RHS we have to get 1. So, we have the identity, since we have sec theta plus tan theta here. If we get sec theta minus tan theta in this bracket, already we have sec theta plus tan theta here. So, if we get sec theta minus tan theta in this bracket, then their product is sec square theta minus tan square theta. And the value of sec square theta minus tan square theta is 1. So, we have to try to get sec theta plus sec theta minus tan theta in this bracket, and we can easily get, just we have to multiply by this sec theta to the 1 minus sin theta, and you will get sec theta minus tan theta there. So, how to simplify this? What is there in the right side that we have to observe first, and according to that RHS, we have to change, we have to make the changes into the LHS. Only two ways we have, that is simplification and using the identities. So, first we will simplify, we will multiply this 1 minus sin theta by sec theta, and then we will use the identity. So, this is sec theta into 1 is sec theta minus sin theta multiplied by sec theta, bracket close, into the second bracket sec theta plus tan theta as it is. Now, here we will write this sec theta as it is minus, this is sin theta upon cos theta. How we get this cos theta? We can write this sec theta as 1 upon cos theta. We will write this sec theta as 1 upon cos theta. 1 multiplied by sin theta is sin theta and cos theta as it is. This bracket close, into the second bracket sec theta plus tan theta. Now, this is sec theta minus tan theta into the first bracket, into the second bracket sec theta plus tan theta. And the product is sec square theta minus tan square theta, using the identity a plus b into a minus b, that is equal to a square minus b square. This is a plus b, this is a minus b, and their product is a square minus b square. And we have identity, that is sec square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. It is an identity. So, we have LHS is equals to RHS. LHS, and we get RHS from it. So, this is all about the first example. We will take next example. Second example from the question number 5 from problem set 6, and the question is, into the first bracket sec theta plus tan theta, bracket close, into the second bracket one minus sin theta, that is equals to cos theta. If we observe this example carefully, the first example and the second example is not the different, the same example is given. Just we simplify the first example before this from the question number 5, and we have the second example, and both the examples are same. Just in the previous example, this cos theta is here in the multiplication at the left side in the form of sec theta. And if we transfer this sec theta to the right side, it will went to the right side 1 upon sec theta, and that is cos theta. It means that we do not have to give the solution also. Same example is there. No change is there. Just the sec theta is here in the LHS. If we transfer this cos theta to this side, it will become 1 upon cos theta, and that will be represented as sec theta. So we have same example, that is example number 1, but we have to simplify this also. So same method we have to use here, since we have sec theta plus tan theta into 1 minus sin theta, and we have to get cos theta. So here we will write LHS first, that is sec theta plus tan theta, bracket close, into 1 minus sin theta. It is equal to, we write LHS as it is. Now we have to get RHS. So we can write this as 1 upon cos theta, we can write this as sin theta upon cos theta. Both the ratios having same denominator, that is cos theta, so you can directly take the addition 1 plus sin theta. Then 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta is 1 minus sin square theta, and in place of 1 minus sin square theta, we can write cos square theta. So we will changes, we will make the changes like that. We will write 1 upon cos theta in place of sec theta. We will write sin theta upon cos theta in place of tan theta, and the second bracket as it is, that is 1 minus sin theta. So we will take the addition of these two. This cos theta is the denominator, which is same. So directly you can add the numerator, that is 1 plus sin theta, and it is multiplied by, this is 1 minus sin theta. Nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there. So we will take the multiplication of numerator, that is a plus b into a minus b. So you can write it as 1 minus sin square theta, that is a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. This is cos theta into 1 is cos theta. You can write this 1 minus sin square theta as cos square theta. Since we have identity sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, we can write cos square theta in place of 1 minus sin square theta, and this cos theta remains as it is. Now this cos theta and this square gets cancelled, and we have cos theta, which is RHS. So here you can write LHS is equals to RHS. We write LHS here and we get RHS. The example is same, but the solution is not the same. Solution is different. So you have to think carefully about that. We will take next example, that is example number 3. Third example from the question number 5, that is sec square theta plus cosec square theta, it is equal to sec square theta into cosec square theta. We have to prove that LHS is equal to RHS. The question is, prove the followings. We have to prove the trigonometric algebraic expressions, that is trigonometric expression sec square theta plus cosec square theta is equal to sec square theta into cosec square theta. So we will first write LHS as it is, that is sec square theta plus cosec square theta is equals to. Now here if you want to use the identities, see the same ratios which we have in the left side, we have to get the same ratios in the right side. And if we use the identities here, we have many identities, we have to use the particular identities there to get sec square theta into cosec square theta. So you have to think about that. So we cannot write in place of sec square theta, we cannot write 1 plus tan square theta, because there is no tan square theta in the RHS. We cannot write 1 plus cot square theta in place of cosec square theta. So we have to think about the other identities. So we can write sec square theta as 1 upon cos square theta, and we can write cosec square theta as 1 upon sin square theta, as we know that sec theta is 1 upon cos theta and cosec theta is 1 upon sin theta, we write sec square theta is equal to 1 upon cos square theta plus 1 upon sin square theta in place of cosec square theta. Now you have to take the addition, is multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is sin square theta into cos square theta. Now cross multiplication is to the numerator, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta. Now we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So we have 1 upon sin square theta into cos square theta. And this is 1 upon sin square theta is cosec square theta, and 1 upon cos square theta is sec square theta. So we can write this as, see, nothing is there in the multiplication means we have 1 beside the 1. Nothing is there in the multiplication means we have 1 there. So this is 1 upon sin square theta is cosec square theta multiplied by 1 upon cos square theta is sec square theta. So this is LHS is equal to RHS. We will take next example, that is example number 4. Number 4 from the question number 5. The example is tan to the power 4 theta plus tan square theta is equal to sec to the power 4 theta minus sec square theta. We have to prove that LHS is equal to RHS. So we will first write LHS as it is here. This is tan to the power 4 theta plus tan square theta. We write the LHS as it is. Now we have to take tan square theta common from both these terms. So here we take tan square theta common. So inside the bracket, what is remaining there? We have tan to the power 4 theta, that is we have tan theta 4 times. We take 2 times common, that is tan square theta. So what is remaining there inside the bracket? That is tan square theta plus, we already take this tan square theta as common, so we have 1 there. Now this tan square theta remains as it is. In place of this 1 plus tan square theta, we have to write sec square theta, as we have identity, that is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. It is an identity. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. It is an identity. So here we will write in place of 1 plus tan square theta, we write sec square theta. Now in place of this tan square theta, see this, if we transfer this 1 to the left side, we will get sec square theta minus 1 is equal to tan square theta. So in place of this tan square theta, this tan square theta, in place of this tan square theta, we have to write sec square theta minus 1, and we write it is sec square theta minus 1 multiplied by sec square theta as it is. Now take the multiplication, is sec square theta into sec square theta, that is sec to the power 4 theta minus sec square theta into 1, that is sec square theta, which is RHS. LHS is equal to RHS. Now we will take next example, it is example number 5. Example number 5, we have given the trigonometric expression and we have to prove that LHS and RHS are equal. See the given expression, cot square theta minus tan square theta is equal to cosec square theta minus sec square theta. So here we will write RHS as it is and we will get LHS. We will write RHS here because it is too easy. If we write in place of cosec square theta, suppose you write 1 plus cot square theta, and here we write 1 plus tan square theta, then plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled and we will get cot square theta minus tan square theta. It is too easy. So we will take RHS here as it is and we will get LHS from the RHS. So here we will write RHS, that is cosec square theta minus sec square theta is equal to. Now in place of cosec square theta, we have to write 1 plus cot square theta. It is an identity. Minus in place of sec square theta, we have to write 1 plus tan square theta. It is also an identity. We use two identities in the one first step only. At a time we use two identities. We write 1 plus cot square theta in place of cosec square theta minus we write 1 plus tan square theta in place of sec square theta. But we take see this step, it is very important. We write the identity inside the bracket since we have to multiply each and every term by this minus sign. And if you do not draw the bracket there, you are not going to multiply each and every term by that sign. So we have to put the bracket there. That is very important. So here 1 plus cot square theta as it is. Now this minus into plus is minus 1, minus into plus is minus tan square theta. This plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. And we have cot square theta minus tan square theta, which is LHS. We write RHS here and we get LHS. It is too easy. In the third step only we get RHS. So this is all about the example number 5. We will take next example, that is example number 6. Example number 6, we have to prove that 1 upon 1 minus sin theta plus 1 upon 1 plus sin theta is equal to 2 into sec square theta. So here we will write LHS as it is, that is 1 upon 1 minus sin theta plus 1 upon 1 plus sin theta. And first of all we have to simplify this. We have to take the product of denominator to the denominator and cross multiplication to the numerator. So the multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is 1 minus sin theta into 1 plus sin theta. Now cross multiplication, 1 into 1 plus sin theta, that is 1 plus sin theta only, plus 1 into 1 minus sin theta is 1 minus sin theta. Now here plus sin theta minus sin theta gets cancelled. We have 1 plus 1, 2 into the numerator. And into the denominator is a plus b into a minus b. We can write it as a square minus b square, that is square of the first term 1 square minus square of the second term, that is sine square theta. Now you can write this as 2 upon 1 minus sine square theta, which is represented as cos square theta. This is 2 upon cos square theta. Now see this 2 as it is, nothing is there in the multiplication with 2, means we have 1 there. We'll put this 2 as it is multiplied by 1 upon cos square theta is nothing but it is sec square theta. You can write the identity here, 1 upon cos theta is equals to sec theta. So we write LHS here and we get the RHS, that is 2 into sec square theta. So you can write here, this is LHS is equals to RHS. This is all about example number 6. We will take next example, example number 7. Example number 7 from the question number 5 from the problem set 6. The question is again same. We have to prove that LHS and RHS are equal. Here the LHS is sec to the power 6x minus tan to the power 6x, that is equal to 1 plus 3 into sec square x into tan square x. We have to prove that LHS and RHS are equal. So here we will first write LHS here as it is, that is sec to the power 6x minus tan to the power 6x. And now it is very important, the first step is very important. We have to write this sec to the power 6 x as, this is sec square x to the power 3. See we have here sec square x cube, sec square x cube. Now here if we use the rule of index, we will get sec to the power 6x as it is, because the rule what it says, if a to the power m and bracket raised to power n, then we have to write a to the power m n. Using that rule you can write it as again sec to the power 6x minus, similarly in the same way we have to write this tan to the power 6x as, this is tan square x cube. We write it as in the form a cube minus b cube. We write it into the form a cube minus b cube, and now we have an identity there. That is, see, the identity is very important. The identity is a cube minus b cube is equals to, this is a cube minus b cube is equals to, into the first bracket a minus b bracket cube plus 3ab into bracket a minus b. That is an identity. A cube minus b cube is equal to into the first bracket a minus b bracket cube plus 3ab into the bracket a minus b. That is nothing but that is just a cubic expansion. बऱ्याचशा विद्यार्थ्यांना ही आयडेंटिटी माहीत नसते, मग त्यांना असं वाटतं किंवा काहीतरी वेगळंच काहीतरी इथं लिहिलेलं आहे. वेगळं असं काहीच नाही लिहिलेलं, हे क्युबिक एक्सपन्शन आहे. फक्त डिफरन्स ऑफ द टू क्युबिक टर्म्स, म्हणजे डिफरन्स बिटवीन द टू टर्म्स, त्याचं क्युबिक एक्सपन्शन आहे. आय विल एक्सप्लेन हिअर, इथे एक्सप्लेन करून दाखवतो मी तुम्हाला. ए मायनस बी ब्रॅकेट क्यूब असं असेल तर आपण त्याला ए क्यूब मायनस 3ab इंटू ब्रॅकेट ए मायनस बी मायनस बी क्यूब असं लिहितात. आता आपण काय केलेलं आहे, फक्त हा ए क्यूब आणि हा बी क्यूब मायनस बी क्यूब इथं ॲज इट इज ठेवलेले आहेत, आणि हे जे रिमेनिंग टर्म आहे का, हे टर्म याला मात्र आपण शिफ्ट केलेलं आहे लेफ्ट साईडला. सो हा ए मायनस बी ब्रॅकेट क्यूब ॲज इट इज राहतो, हे टर्म निगेटिव्ह आहे, लेफ्ट साईडला ट्रान्सफर केलं तर पॉझिटिव्ह होत आहे. 3ab into bracket a minus b as it is, that is equals to a cube minus b cube. वेगळं काहीच नाही आहे, हे क्युबिक एक्सपन्शनच आहे. फक्त त्या क्युबिक एक्सपन्शनमधील एक टर्म जे सेंटरला आहे, मिडल टर्म आहे, ते लेफ्ट साईडला ट्रान्सफर केलं आणि आपल्याला a cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b whole cube that plus 3ab into bracket a minus b मिळालेलं आहे. सो वी हॅव टू यूज दॅट आयडेंटिटी हिअर, दी आयडेंटिटी इज एक्सप्लेन्ड हिअर. बऱ्याचशा स्टुडंट्सला हे माहिती असतं क्युबिक एक्सपन्शन, 8 स्टँडर्डपासून आपण अभ्यासात आलेलो आहोत, पण डायरेक्टली असं लिहिलं की त्यांना ते लक्षात येत नाही. सो इथं ते एक्सप्लेन केलेलं आहे, ए मायनस बी ब्रॅकेट क्यूब दॅट इज इक्वल टू ए क्यूब मायनस 3ab इंटू ब्रॅकेट ए मायनस बी मायनस बी क्यूब. आपल्याला ए क्यूब मायनस बी क्यूबच्या स्वरूपात हा भाग अवेलेबल आहे, म्हणून आपण हे टर्म इकडे शिफ्ट केलं तर ए मायनस बी ब्रॅकेट क्यूब प्लस 3ab इंटू ब्रॅकेट a minus b that is equals to a cube minus b cube. So ही जी identity आहे, identity अत्यंत important आहे. example तितकंसं अवघड नाही आहे, परंतु जी identity आपण यूज केलेली आहे ती identity मात्र अत्यंत महत्त्वाची आहे. So we have to write this a cube minus b cube in this form a minus b bracket cube plus 3ab into bracket a minus b. So first we will write into the first bracket what we have to write, क्यूब रूट ऑफ बोथ द टर्म्स अँड ब्रॅकेट क्यूब दॅट इज सेक स्क्वेअर यक्स मायनस टॅन स्क्वेअर यक्स ब्रॅकेट क्यूब प्लस 3 इंटू ए दॅट इज सेक स्क्वेअर यक्स इंटू बी दॅट इज टॅन स्क्वेअर यक्स इंटू द ब्रॅकेट ए मायनस बी दॅट इज सेक स्क्वेअर यक्स मायनस टॅन स्क्वेअर यक्स. इट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. Now, as we know that sec square x minus tan square x is equal to 1, it is an identity. Actual identity is sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. That is the actual identity. But if we transfer tan square theta to the left side, we will get sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Here we have x. So, sec square x minus tan square x is nothing but that is 1 cube of it plus 3 multiplied by this is sec square x into tan square x as it is multiplied by the value of sec square x minus tan square x is 1 again. So you can simplify this, 1 cube is 1 plus 3 into 1 that is 3 into sec square x into tan square x which is RHS, 1 plus 3 sec square x into tan square x. So here you can write LHS is equal to RHS. See, the example is too easy, but this identity is very important. And this conversion, sec to the power 6 x is converted into sec square x bracket cube minus tan to the power 6 x is converted at tan square x to the bracket cube. And then we use the identity a cube minus b cube is equals to a minus b bracket cube plus 3ab into the bracket a minus b. So this is all about the example number 7. We will take next example, example number 8. Example number 8 from the question number 5. Tan theta upon sec theta plus 1 is equal to sec theta minus 1 upon tan theta. Here we have to prove that LHS and RHS are equal. So here we will write RHS as it is, that is sec theta minus 1 upon tan theta. We write RHS as it is. And now we have only one way, that is we have to make the rationalization of numerator. So here we will make the rationalization of numerator. As we have sec theta minus 1 there upon tan theta as it is, we have to take the rationalization of numerator, means we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate pair of numerator, that is sec theta plus 1. We multiply both the numerator and denominator by sec theta plus 1. Here sec theta minus 1 into sec theta plus 1, the multiplication is sec square theta minus 1 divided by this tan theta into the bracket sec theta plus 1 as it is. Now you have to simplify this. Sec square theta minus 1 is nothing but that is tan square theta. It is an identity. Sec square theta minus 1 is nothing but it is tan square theta. You can write here identity, sec square theta minus 1 is equals to tan square theta upon tan theta into the bracket sec theta plus 1 as it is. Here this square and this tan theta cancel and we have tan theta upon sec theta plus 1, which is LHS. We write RHS here and we get LHS. So here you can write RHS is equals to LHS. This is all about the example number 8. We will take next example, that is example number 9. Example number 9 from the question number 5. We have to prove that tan cube theta minus 1 upon tan theta minus 1, it is equal to sec square theta plus tan theta. So here we will first write the LHS as it is, that is tan cube theta minus 1 upon tan theta minus 1. That is LHS, we write it as it is. Now see, this is in the form a cube minus b cube. It's tan cube theta and 1 is nothing but that is the cube of 1. And this tan theta minus 1 remains as it is. Now we have to use identity here. A cube minus b cube is equal to into the first bracket a minus b into the second bracket a square plus ab plus b square. It is an identity. If we have a cube minus b cube, then you can represent it into the form, into the first bracket difference of the cube roots of both the terms, and from the first bracket we have to get the second bracket, that is a square. Opposite sign is here, plus product of both the term and then second term square, that is b square. So we have to represent this a cube minus b cube in this form, into the first bracket cube root of both the terms, means we have to write into the first bracket tan theta minus 1, into the second bracket square of the first term, that is tan square theta. Then we have to write opposite sign, that is plus product of both the terms tan theta into 1, that is tan theta, plus the square of the second term, that is 1, divided by this tan theta minus 1 remains as it is, and these two brackets are gets cancelled. Tan theta minus 1, tan theta minus 1 gets cancelled, and we have tan square theta plus tan theta plus 1. And you can write it as tan square theta plus 1 plus tan theta. Just we change the order of these two terms. We write 1 as first, 1 before tan theta, and then we will write tan theta there. Why we write like this? Because we have an identity, that is 1 plus tan square theta is nothing but sec square theta. So here we will write sec square theta plus this tan theta remains as it is, and that is nothing but RHS. So here we write the LHS and we get the RHS. It is too easy, but this identity is very important. That is, a cube minus b cube is equal to into the first bracket a minus b into the second bracket a square plus ab plus b square. So this is all about the example number 9. We will take next example, that is last example from this question number 5, that is example number 10.